Okay. And then I'm also going to make the mutual personal box. I can go a little bit, lingo a little more. And then I'm going to go into the occlusal table, but making sure that I'm centering the grooves in the into my prep, and I don't do the punch, but I right away go into the full depth, which this 3030 body is 1.6 mm, so I just go at the full depth, so which is safe because the depth needs to be 1.5 to 2 mm. And check whether I'm going into the right direction. Check it, and I'm going to go into the groove here, vocal groove. Mm-hmm. I'm slightly off, but I'm going to include it as I'm going to widen it. So since this portion is kinda taller than this area, I need to use a brush stroke, brush motion to cut, which is a deeper portion, deeper than this 330 bar. 330 bar is only 1.5, but this portion is about 1.7, so I need to make it a brush stroke for me to extend it. Okay, and then I'm going to cross this oblique ridge, but let me approach it from the distal side. And also at the full depth of the burr. And follow the slope. As you can see, there is a slope, so I need to follow as I go up like this. I need to follow its slope. And as I go down, I also need to follow its slope. make sure that I am going into the groove. So I can also approach it from here. I can also approach from the groove, lingual groove. It needs to be 1 mm in depth and also width. I'm fond of using 57 bursts on this area, but now I just initially drilled with 330. Okay, so it was the initial cut. I'm going to connect this oblique ridge. At the full depth, and then round everything off. Some points where the cover surface margin is taller than this 30-30 burr, you need to cut the cover surface first, detaching it from the floor and letting the flute touch the margin area, and then go lower, making the internal wall, the external wall of the floor area flat. Touch the proximal area. And then S curve. Evaluation. So this is my initial cut. I'm going to refine it, making the isthmus 1 mm.
How was the exam?
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah?
Good recording. No. So, using the NML headset. Use the vertical cutting. And also you can extend the eggshell wall by cutting the eggshell wall with enamel hatchet. Having the sharp instruments are very important, so you can sharpen. You need to learn how to sharpen your instrument. If you have a dull instrument, it's just a slice, not cutting the surface. So, and I see many people who do not know how to sharpen, so please learn how to sharpen. I have a separate video for sharpening. So just to cut it, since it is a composite, you don't need a convergency, it is not a requirement. So not chipping it off, I just to cut it with the vertical force. And I'm gonna extend it a little bit more with the enamel hatchet, the eggshell wall. Because this instrument is 1.2 mm, so it needs more room than the 1 mm enamel hatchet. But this is better somehow, because it has a less chance it to slip and damage the gingival floor. So check with the exploder. This is slightly tight. This side seems to be okay, but this side is tight. So you can flatten the gingival floor by pushing, scraping. Make sure that the cover surface is 90 degrees. Your finger might feel pain, but that is one of the process of having gaining muscles of your fingers, so you need to used to it, and later on you do not feel that fatigue using the animal hatchet. So practice, you'll see that your hands get used to it. Used to it.
Stop it, please. Honestly, it's so offensive. Don't offend me right now. You are offending me right now. Stop.
Okay. Now you can see that this is following the contour, right? So if you want to adjust, you can use the. You can cut the eggshell wall using the animal hatchet, because that is kind of difficult to make it nice using the burr only. So use this flat instrument to cut the places where you want it to be modified. In my eyes, it looks good here, and also this one is also looking good, but I will define it more. So this angled one has two different angles, though it seems to be the same, but the cutting edge one is like the one is cutting edge is this side and the other one is inner. And by using like rubbing motion, you can also cut and this smoothen the wall. And if you have a 1mm instrument, you can check the smooth size. This is a 1mm gingival margin trimmer. So it is slightly tight here, and this one is very tight, and this one is also tight. So I'm going to use 330 burr to smoothen. As I smoothen, I'm going to widen the isthmus. I don't need to go deeper because I achieved the depth from the initial phase. And make the S curve. Gently curving up, and also here. This is a sharp. This is a sharp, so I'm going to round it up. And then internal. After hitting the cover surface, I go to the deeper for me to make the wall flat. Like this. And then let's widen it. You see? 5.7. So 5.7 burr, its diameter is 1 mm. So 1 mm in width and the depth, width and the like 0.8, but according to the manufacturer it is a 1 mm, but I don't know why it is only 0.8. So depending on the company, it differs a little bit, so just refer to them, their measurement. And it is good to have a caliper for you to measure it by yourself. Or probably this bird is not 57 but 56. But it gives this bird gives a very straight, clean cut. And let's check with the 1 mm instrument. Anything 1 mm is good to be used. Almost. Then you can just widen it. Perfect 1 mm using this 1 mm instrument. By inserting it forcefully, you can actually cut it. See, like this. But be careful not to chip it off like that. Chipping off is always dangerous because the margin might be also break along with it. As I did here, I chipped a little bit of margin area here because I used the chipping motion. So chipping motion needs to be prevented, but the cutting motion is okay. This is cutting motion, and this is a chipping motion. So I need to evaluate which cut to cut, whether this or either this or this. But upon my evaluation, it is better to cut this cusp because it is a bigger. And also I can make the floor flat using this. For the lingual, the depth also needs to be 1 mm. So 1 mm. As long as this instrument fits, it's a 1 mm because it is a 1 mm instrument. And it is still, now it is 1 mm because it is passing through. Thank you. good. And this side is also almost 1 mm. Let me twist and cut. Yeah, now it is 1 mm. Once it passes, the second is easy. This one is also 1 mm. For the exam, these measurements are very important. But bigger than 1 mm is okay, but less than 1 mm is problematic because we cannot introduce our condensers. So, yeah, basically it looks good. And I should not forget to bevel the actual purple line angle. So this one is for the Michel side. So the way we use the gingival margin trimmer is putting it into the corner and then twist it. Corner and twist it. Engage into the corner and twist it. That's it. You don't need to do a lot. As long as you can see some bevel, then that is good enough. And also for the distal side, engage if this is the distal side. Engage and twist. And this is broken. Too bad. Engage and twist. And just define the wall a little bit. Making it more clean. But I usually use an enamel hatchet to define. So, and also I see some irregularity on this floor, so let's clean. Just scrape. By scraping it, you can make the floor smoother and cleaner. And if you can use a polishing strip, use your polishing strip to go through interproximal area and clean. You see how it became clean with the polishing strip. Clean up any debris. Like this. And also this side, this one needs to be also beveled. This needs to be also beveled. So, no sharp area, because these are the occlusal tables, so if there is some occlusal load, then the restoration might break. Yeah, so good, it looks good. And also for the composite in the school where I'm studying, we give a buccal and a facial bevel, but not occlusal area. So the way you make the bevel is just to scrape this area 45, just like 0.5 mm. Yeah, I'm just cleaning the wall, not keeping the bevel. But so there are those techniques that you can use. So that's it today. MODL, case number 14.